Welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Roma in Full Manager 2019. I'm Ater, and right now we are looking at my finances. And as you can tell, they are pretty crappy. I mean, we are in the reds for this season, but that will probably change because hopefully we have some prize money coming on later in the season. But look at this transfer budget and the wage budget and omitted wage budget for next season. And also, we are only getting to keep 80% of transfer revenue that's made available. And I mean, our finances wasn't great before, but the reason that it's changed like this is we have actually, well, first off, signed a new contract with a few players, not that you need to go through all that, but that means the wages are going up and so on. But the main thing is we have made a new signing. Of course, that player won't be joining us until the summer, but we have spent a decent amount for a player that I'm really excited for. I think it's a perfect fit for our team. But of course, we need to leave you with a little bit of a cliffhanger. So we're going to take a look at that player after today's game. And today's game, if you take a look at the schedule, you can tell that, first off, we have quite a few games to talk about. Last episode, we played Juve. And after Juve game, we beat Genoa. We beat Juve once again in the Italian Cup. Then we beat Palermo. And in the last game, we got a draw away versus Benfica in the Champions League first knockout round. And of course, we won the first leg big, so I was pretty secure for this one. And we had a lot of rotations. And we have had some injury problems, so I was actually using a few youth players and so on, but we still managed to get a decent result, and we managed to get through to the quarterfinal. We still don't know what team we will get, but to show things off right now, Real Madrid managed to knock out Juve, Dortmund actually managed to knock out Barcelona, and Liverpool managed to knock out Valencia. Then there are quite a few teams left that haven't played yet. We are going to find out who between PSG and City, Olympique Lyons versus United, Chelsea versus Atletico Madrid, and Porto versus Arsenal. So quite a few games left to be decided, and yeah, it's going to be interesting to see who we get in the quarter final. Today's episode, we are playing Sampdoria, and I have a few reasons for going with this team as this episode, because I wasn't quite sure what we were going to go for. I would say the next big game we have is the quarterfinal in the Champions League. But if I would wait this one with recording a new episode, I mean, this would have been like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 games between episodes. And I feel like that's a little bit too much. I want you to be involved in this save and see what's going on and so on. So we needed a save a little bit earlier, or a game a little bit earlier. And also, of course, I was excited to show off the transfer. And then, actually, between the teams we have left before the quarterfinal, Sampdoria is actually the one that's currently doing best in the league. Bologna down to 15, AC Milan 10th, Spal 14th. So Sampdoria, I think, is the winner. And also, I believe it's the first time we are playing them in an episode. And that's great. And we are still dominating the league, still amount of points down to the second place team as last time checked, and Arp is the top goal scorer, so everything is going our way in the league. Talking about the team, we have had quite a few injuries. Most of them are back. The only major one right now is Santon, and he's going to be back in about 2 weeks. He got like a 1 month injury, and because of him, I brought up kind of a garbage player. No insulting here, but he's clearly not Serie A class, at least. And he is an example of a player that played in the last game in Champions League. And we also have two players that are currently suspended. Schick and Inda. Schick picked up a red card in his last game, so very annoying. Marin is back from his injury, lacking match fitness, of course. Fossat, also a backup. Goalkeepers have been injured, but he is back in business. And yeah, that's where we are right now, and because of these injuries and suspensions, I actually have quite a few youngsters from my youth team. Actually, only three of them right now, but I haven't used more in the past because of Missing players, and as you can tell, we need to give a player a number. I was actually considering bringing in one more youth player, but he was lacking fitness because they played a game, I think, yesterday or something like that. So this is the Sampdoria team we are up against, and yeah, hopefully we can do well as always, and keep our journey towards the title going. And as long as we do that, of course, the title is coming to us. But I probably shouldn't get cocky because this game tends to punish you when you do. But yeah, I can give you some more spoilers of our new signing or our upcoming signing. And then maybe you can actually, because you might have seen or heard about him previously in this save, and maybe you can get some ideas or something like that. So this is a player that we are signing for from Man City, and Man City signed him only a season ago. So he's currently doing his second season for Man City. They signed him for 45 million, and now he's worth, I think, almost 60 mil. And here we have a penalty. And let's see here. Pereira sets up. Actually, in one of the previous games, I don't remember which one they were. Schick scored 4 goals, but he also missed a penalty, so he could have scored 5. But this time, Schick's not on the pitch. Pereira takes the penalty, and he makes no mistake at all. Yeah, worth around 58 mil. And the reason for me signing him right now, because I usually kind of try to stick to transfer windows if nothing special happens, is he actually got transfer listed, and he got transfer listed for 29 mil. So he's worth almost 60, transfer listed for 29. And I still was like, maybe I should wait, but the Barcelona had a major interest in him, like not a minor but a major interest, and this is bad news for us. This that's no wait wait maybe Maybe it's nothing. We have a VAR thingy, and look at it. Yeah, clearly offside. He was, huge offside there. But yeah, Barcelona had a high interest in him, so I felt like, yeah, I don't want to sh take a chance and wait. I'm going to try to sign him ASAP, and we managed to. Even for the contract negotiations, he was saying like, "Yeah, Barcelona is keeping an eye on me, so you better make me happy." And right now, I'm not happy. Look at some of the rating. 6.4, 6.4, 6.5. This is garbage ratings. The lads need to know I'm not pleased. We need to step it up for the second half. And I think I'm actually going to try bringing Nsosi a little bit higher up into the pitch. See if that works better. While doing that, we're also going to tell some lads to chill with the tackles. Because as you saw, we already have two players suspended for this game, because of yellow and red cards, so we don't need any more of that. But yeah, so we managed to get him, and I'm very happy. And if I'm remembering things right, another hint, if I'm remembering things right, he is 24 years old, so he's still pretty young, but I might be, I think he's 24, if I'm remembering things right. And the reason for me signing him, of course, he's a good player. Of course, he's a player that I scouted before in this save. But he also plays in a position where we have a player right now that is really good, but he's also really old, going to turn 34 next season, and his stats is declining. So I think it could be a perfect timing to basically find this replacement. Now enough of spoilers here. We are going to take a look at him really soon. But first, let's take a look here if it's time to make some subs. Gerson, 6.4. Nervous. I'm sorry, but you have to go, mate. Let's bring in the Kluivert. Of course, Ünder is suspended, so we can't bring him on. I mean, Pellegrini is motivated, but he's not playing that good. I mean, Nsosi is composed, and he's playing better. And then Pellegrini has the yellow card, so I think we're gonna bring in Cristante instead, and let's keep it like this for now. But yeah, this is clearly not one of our greatest games. And to talking about that, here is Sampdoria, and this could be a penalty. I think it is a penalty. Hopefully, he wasn't over the line and he was outside the box, but I felt like he was inside. Maybe it's just to fall inside. But this could definitely be a penalty. Yeah, it is a penalty. So we are most likely going to see the equalizer here. Come on, Donnarumma, I believe in you, I trust you. And I shouldn't, that was a mistake. I don't trust you anymore, Donnarumma. But yeah, clearly it wasn't his fault. But yeah, I feel like this haven't been 1 hour. Oh my god, what was that? You just throw yourself and land basically where you were standing. Now I think we're gonna go in saucy, tired, and I don't like that body language. And what can we tell? Demand more, maybe. But yeah, we have created a lot of chances here if you look at statistics, but we haven't seen much. Or maybe this could be it. Parade over the corner is clear by defense. Kluivert picks it up. Cristante, and he finds Barbosa and his 10th goal this season. And oh my god, an important one. Hopefully a three-pointer. But yeah, let's take a look at the replay here. Parade over the corner, clear by the defense. Kluivert picks it up for Cristante, finds Barbosa in the box, and with a little bit of luck, it finds the net. And it's no offside for Barbosa. It's that guy that's offside. He's not affected. But here is a corner for Sampdoria. Something ASAP. Kluivert picks that one up. Tonality. Hopefully, this is just the end of the game because I'm not feeling this game at all right now. I'm clearly not one of the best games we played this season, and there's a lot of room for improvement for the next one. But oh, decent try there by Kluivert. I was about to say that that could be a goal, but the extra time is up, so the ref should be blowing the whistle here at any second. Pereira with last corner, probably cleared. Upamecano. The extra time is going on for a long time. What's up with that? Pellegrini, Schüle. Go home to Donnarumma. Yep. Smart. Donnarumma. Upamecano. You can just pass it around there. No stress at all. That's the full-time whistle. And I tell them right now, we got away with that today. You were poor out there. We need to be much better when it comes up against better sides. And yeah, the defense got some good ratings, but the midfield and the attack is garbage. So I think this is okay one. I hope the defense doesn't get too upset with that. And most of them agreed, brilliant. So let's get to that signing then. And the player, one last hint here. The player I'm signing him to replace is Nsosi. Nsosi is really good and he's been great for us. But he will be turning 34. During next season, as you can tell, some of his stats has already started declining. And last time I checked him, it was I think some other stats that were going down. So he's really good, but I feel like his time is about to end at the club, and we need somebody that can rotate to get it with Tonali. And the transfer that we have secured is Locatelli from Man City, and hopefully he still got room to improve a bit. But he will be our new defensive midfielder that will be rotating together with Tonali next season. And as I said, worth 58 mil, transfer listed for 29. Barcelona wanted him, had a major interest, and yeah, I'm very pleased, especially since he's Italian, getting another Italian player in the club. I think it's perfect, and yeah, I'm very happy with this one. Especially since we only had to play 29 mil, but now our finances is garbage, and we'll have to see what we can do during the summer to change that. But that's it for this episode. As always, thank you so much for sharing your time with me, and also let me know in the comments what you think about this signing. But yeah, I'll see you in the next episode.